So as far as we know, in the Dragon Ball Super anime, the angels are masters of Ultra Instinct. While the gods of destruction, even with their immense power, for the most part, they all seem to struggle with the technique. Guys, I've been wanting to do this video for a while, and I'm so excited that I get to finally share it with you today. In my opinion, so far in the series, the creators have been setting up Vegeta to become a god of destruction, while Goku's story so far has focused more on building him up as an angelic character, someone who is more likely to play the role of an angel later on. I think there is very strong evidence in this series to support both of those statements, and that is what I will be going through in this video. But real quick before I get into it, guys, my name is Dooley. You can find me at youtube.com/Dooley, but you won't just find me, you will also find a community of over 52,000 Dragon Ball Super fans, a growing family, and you are welcome to join. You can do so by clicking the subscribe button below this video or the link in the description. If you do decide to do that, then welcome to the family in advance. Also, guys, we have a Discord. If you want to hang out with some cool Dragon Ball Super people, then go ahead and join the Discord. Link is in the description as well. Now let's hop into this video. In episode 16 of Dragon Ball Super, Whis tells Vegeta that he will agree to train him under the condition that Vegeta becomes a god of destruction. At the time in the series, the concept of gods and angel was still pretty new to all of us, so I think a lot of us may have overlooked that condition for Vegeta's training, especially since we had just seen Goku become Super Saiyan God for the first time. Now, however, we are approaching the end of Dragon Ball Super, and we have a much better idea of what a God of Destruction actually is. It pretty much revolves around the ability to use and control Hakai energy, destruction energy. Yes, the God of Destructions do play a role in balancing the universe, but that's for another video. For now, we're just gonna talk about the physicality, personality, and general power of these immensely powerful beings, because I think if we had paid closer attention to this condition from Whis to Vegeta, we would have had a very clear roadmap as to Vegeta's development. We would have known what to expect from Vegeta in the Tournament of Power and beyond, about things like the mastery of Ultra Instinct, for example. Guys, if it sounds like I'm going off course, stick with me, because I promise I'm gonna tie it all together before the end of this video. Let's keep going. A bit later in the series, in episode 18, we got a scene where Whis described to Vegeta and Goku their weaknesses. He's telling them what they need to improve on in order to achieve Ultra Instinct. And I'm gonna paraphrase a little bit, but pretty much it boils down to Whis telling Vegeta that he is too tense, while Goku, on the other hand, was too relaxed. Now guys, which one of these traits do you think better matches the role of destruction? In my opinion, it's the person who's too tense, while the person who is relaxed very closely matches what we've seen from the angels so far. In fact, regardless of the situation, even when the entire universe is on the line, or they're gods of destruction, people that they've known for millions of years apparently, even when their gods of destructions are erased in front of their eyes, the angels still appear to be completely relaxed. While the gods of destruction, on the other hand, they appear more tense. They appear to be more prone to fear and anger, etc., etc. And you can argue that this is because there hasn't really been a significant threat to the angels in the series so far. And that's a fair criticism, but I think even in situations where there's no significant threat to the gods of destruction, they still appear far more tense than the angels are. A perfect example is the tournament between Universe 6 and 7. Beerus and Champa were on tense overload, and there were really no significant threat to them in that arc. Even as far back as when Beerus first fought Goku in Super Saiyan God, we now know that Super Saiyan God Goku with the red hair was little to no threat to Beerus. But still, there were scenes in that fight where Beerus was extremely tense and worked up. My reason for elaborating this is because I believe that that tension, that personality trait, actually works against the gods of destruction when it comes to their ability to achieve and master Ultra Instinct. That is why, as far as we know, they have all been training for millions of years, trying to master this technique, but they all still suck at it. And before someone mentions this in the comments, yes, I know that Beerus did use Ultra Instinct in the manga, but we're not talking about the manga here, we're talking about the anime. And even if we did acknowledge Beerus's use of Ultra Instinct in the manga, it didn't look like mastered Ultra Instinct. It wasn't Angel level, in my opinion. It was closer to Ultra Instinct Omen. And this is after millions of years of training. Beerus is likely the strongest god of destruction, and that is all he was able to achieve. I think without a doubt, that is proof that that tenseness, that personality trait that Whis described to Vegeta is why the gods of destruction struggle with achieving Ultra Instinct, and it's also why Vegeta didn't achieve Ultra Instinct in the Tournament of Power. This doesn't mean that Vegeta will never get Ultra Instinct, because Beerus has his own version of it, but I think it means that Vegeta will never master Ultra Instinct in the same way Goku will. The last thing I want to mention real quick regarding Vegeta becoming a god of destruction is in his fight with Toppo. We saw Vegeta destroying Toppo's Hakai energy, his god of destruction energy. And as far as we know so far, the destruction qualities of Hakai energy are above everything else. So the fact that Vegeta was able to destroy Toppo's Hakai energy implies that Vegeta possessed some sort of destruction energy himself, and his destruction energy was on a higher level than Toppo's. So just to wrap all this together, for Vegeta, the fact that Whis's condition to train Vegeta was for him to become a god of destruction, and Whis did train Vegeta, which implies that Vegeta accepted that condition. The fact that Vegeta's weakness and the reason why he struggles with achieving Ultra Instinct is that he's too tense, which is a weakness shared by all of the God of Destructions as far as we know. And also the fact that Vegeta seems to already possess some sort of destruction energy within himself. This is why he was shown destroying Toppo's Hakai energy over and over. In my opinion, these 3 points heavily reinforces the idea that Vegeta will become a god of destruction later on in the series. Now let's move on to Goku. I've already mentioned how Whis's description of Goku's weakness closely mirrored the personality traits of the angels that we've seen in the series so far. Goku is too relaxed, and these angels are relaxed all the time, even in the face of the potential erasure of their universes and their gods of destruction. If that's the case though, you might say, Dooley, why would Whis then tell Goku that him being relaxed is a weakness? Shouldn't that be a strength? And I would agree with you. But I should also add, in that episode, in episode 18, Whis did mention that Goku was further along. He mentioned that it would be easier for Goku to achieve Ultra Instinct than it would be for Vegeta. Of course, at the time, he didn't say Ultra Instinct, but in hindsight, we now know that's what he was talking about. Anyway, I think this being relaxed personality trait of Goku is also present in all the angels. But there are two more very, very important attributes that Goku developed in Dragon Ball Super that makes it hard to deny that Goku is developing angelic attributes. The first one being the new healing abilities that Goku has developed since he was first introduced to God Ki. Now, if you've been following my channel for a while, you've probably heard me talk about this before. I made a video talking about this topic specifically that I'll link right now in a card. But all it is ever since Goku first became a Super Saiyan God, he somehow miraculously developed the ability to rapidly heal himself. He's gained some new powers of restoration and resurrection. Yes, resurrection. This isn't an opinion, it's fact. In his fight with Beerus, Goku was stabbed in his chest and he healed himself to continue that fight. In a later episode, Goku was killed by Hit, who did so much internal damage that Goku literally fell to his death. But Goku's ki was not only able to bring him back to life, it was also able to heal that fatal internal damage. Goku even did it in a Tournament of Power. There was a scene where Master Roshi appeared to have died, and Goku appeared to not only bring Master Roshi back to life, but also healed his wounds. These powers of restoration very, very closely mirror what we've seen the angels do in the series. For example, Whis would sometimes use his healing powers to heal Goku and Vegeta after training, or like when Whis used his powers to bring life into the world early by having Bulma birth Bulla, Vegeta's daughter. My point is, this healing ability from Goku closely matches what we would expect from angels, but if you're not yet convinced, I think without a doubt, there is no denying that Goku's incredibly fast mastery of Ultra Instinct is proof of his potential connection with angelic level power. We have to keep in mind that some of these gods of destruction were likely training for Ultra Instinct for millions of years. On the other hand, Goku, after just a few months of training with Whis, was able to unlock Ultra Instinct and move up to mastering it in less than an hour. We don't know how long it takes the angels to master Ultra Instinct, but I can say for a fact that Goku's time spent mastering the technique is likely much closer to the angel's time than it is to the God of Destruction's time. Also guys, in case you're having a hard time accepting that Goku could master Ultra Instinct this quickly, keep in mind that this has always been a character trope of Goku. For example, it took Master Roshi 50 years to master the Kamehameha, whereas Kid Goku was able to do it in 2 minutes. The same goes for techniques like the Kaioken. No one else has ever been able to do it. Goku mastered it in a very short time. And even the instant transmission, we've never seen anyone outside of the Yadrats use instant transmission, but Goku was able to master it in under 1 year. Anyway, back to the point of this video. In case this angelic connection wasn't obvious enough, the creators of Dragon Ball Super went and made Goku's hair color match the hair color of all the angels we've seen in the series so far while he's using this new technique. I think, guys, that is undeniable proof, or at the very least, very strong evidence that Goku is being set up to play the role of an angel or something like it later on in this series. So to summarize, the series has been setting up Vegeta to play the role of a god of destruction, and at the same time, it's been setting up Goku to play the role of an angel. This is the main reason why it was so difficult for Vegeta to achieve Ultra Instinct, even though he's just as strong as Goku is or was. I don't know if this means that later on, Goku will replace Whis and Vegeta will replace Beerus, although that might make for an interesting video topic. Either way, let me know what you guys think of all this. This was an interesting video to make, so I hope you enjoyed it. As usual, guys, my name is Dooley. Social media links to follow this channel outside of YouTube are in the description, including Discord, #DooCrew. Thank you guys for all the support. Have a great day. Bye.